to the class on chemical kinetics. Today we are going to discuss the molecularity of reactions. Molecularity is the number of molecules of reactants that involved in a step leading to a chemical reaction. Consider a reaction that is the dissociation of nitrogen pentoxide N2O5 in gaseous state to give N2O4 in gaseous state and oxygen, O2. Here, the number of molecules of N2O5 involved in the reaction is equal to 1. So, the molecularity is equal to 1. Molecularity of the reaction is 1. It is a simple reaction. Here, the order from the experiment, it is found that the order of the reaction is also equal to 1. And consider another reaction, the dissociation of hydrogen iodide to give in the gaseous stage to give hydrogen molecule in the gaseous stage and iodine is also in the gaseous stage. It is also a simple reaction. Here the molecularity is equal to 2, that is 2 molecules of hydrogen iodides are involved in the reaction. The molecularity is equal to 2, and there also order is also is equal to 2. Order is obtained from experiment. That is, in some simple reactions, the order is equal to the molecularity. The molecularity is purely a theoretical quantity. It is obtained from the balanced equation. But order is an experimental quantity. It is obtained only after conducting some experiment. But it is found that in some simple reactions like this, the molecularity is equal to order of the reaction. Then consider another reaction, a simple reaction. That is the hydrolysis of acid hydrolysis of ethyl acetate and inversion of cane sugar C12H22O11 or hydrolysis of cane sugar. Here it is also hydrolysis and we can get acetic acid CH3COOH plus ethanol. Here we can get C6H12O6, two molecules of C6H12O6. Here the molecularity is equal to 2, that is one molecule of ester react with one molecule of water to give one molecule of acetic acid and one molecule of ethanol. Here also the molecularity is equal to 2. Here this molecule of sucrose is equal to 1, molecule of water is equal to 1, and we can get one molecule of glucose and one molecule of fructose. So the molecularity is here in both the cases, molecularity is equal to 2. But we this is a simple reaction, so we can expect a number, order of the reaction is also equal to 2. But from this experiment, it is found that the order is not equal to 2, it is equal to 1. Because in these two reactions, we can take one of the reactants in large excess. Here, in these reactions, we can take, in both these reactions, we can take water in large excess. So, as the reaction proceeds, there is no change in the concentration of the water compared to the concentration of the reactants, ester and sucrose. So, the concentration of water is taken as a constant always. We know that the rate of the reaction is expressed is R is equal to K into concentration of ester into concentration of water. Here water is taken in large excess, so it is always a constant. Compared to the change in concentration of ester, the changing concentration of ester is whatever is negligible, so it is always a constant. A constant into another constant, it is equal to a second constant, that is the rate is equal to k into concentration of ester only. In the case of ester hydrolysis, or r is equal to k into concentration of sucrose in the case of hydrolysis of sucrose. So this reaction, the rate is equal to 1. Such reactions are known as the pseudo monomolecular reactions. Pseudo mono or unimolecular reactions. Molecular reactions or pseudo order reactions. Pseudo unimolecular reactions or pseudo order reactions. In pseudo order reactions, one of the reactant is taken in large excess. Simple and complex reactions. Simple reaction means the reaction that completed in a single step is known as simple reaction. For example, decomposition of hydrogen iodide in gaseous phase to give hydrogen and iodine. We already discussed that the molecularity of the reaction is equal to molecularity of the reaction is equal to 2 and order also is equal to 2. That is, for many simple reactions, the order of the reaction is equal to its molecularity. And the complex reaction means the reaction that takes more than one step for completion is known as complex reactions. For example, a reaction that is 3 molecules of A and 2 molecules of B react together to form 2 products P and Q. This reaction involves more than one step. Each step is known as an elementary reaction. If the reaction involves 4 steps, that is, first A plus B react together to form C plus D, 2 intermediates. In the next step, A plus C react to form random intermediate T, and then A react with D gives F, and the last step F react with B gives product P and Q. Here each step is known as an elementary step. Each step has its own molecularity. Each step has its own molecularity depending on the number of molecules involved in the reaction. And each has its own range. But what is the order of the overall reaction and rate of the overall reaction? Suppose the reaction, the first step is the first step, and the second step is also fast. Here the third step is the slowest step, and the fourth step is also fast. Here the rate of the reaction, the overall rate of the reaction cannot be faster than the rate of the slowest step. That is, the rate of the reaction, overall reaction, is the rate of the slowest step. This rate is equal to k into concentration of a to the power x and b to the power y. This is the rate of the, that is, the rate of a complex reaction is the rate of the slowest step of the reaction. And then what is the order of the reaction? Order of the reaction is the order of the slowest step, because it is obtained by an experimental experimentally, and order is also an experimental quantity. So order of the reaction is the order of the Swarovski step, that is n is equal to x plus y. That is, for a complex reaction, each step has its own molecularity, but the order of the overall reaction is the order of the Swarovski step of the reaction, and the rate of the reaction also is the rate of the Swarovski step. That is, the Swarovski step is the rate determining step of a complex reaction. Okay, so I wish to stop here. Thank you for watching.